anything in particular that you think that you find to be really big myths about cholesterol or things that people come out at and you're like, wait, hold on, that is completely not true?
Yeah, there's a lot. There's a lot of mythology around cholesterol.
Yes, there is.
One big one that I see is this idea that it's all genetics. That if you go to the doctor, you get diagnosed with hypercholesterolemia, you know, it's your fate. My father had it. My grandfather had it. There's nothing I can do. It's in the family. It runs in the blood. It does run in the blood, but not. It's not genetic. It's not 100% genetically determined. In fact, studies have shown that you can affect your lipid levels dramatically and within very short time frames. There's a study from a team at the University of Toronto that did a very, very sensational experiment because they compared the effect of diet to taking drugs, taking statins. And what they showed was that the effect was similar. Roughly a 30% drop in both cases in LDL cholesterol within 7 days.
That doesn't mean drugs are useless. For some people, optimizing diet isn't enough and meds can be life-saving. But point is,
with lifestyle, and it's not just diet, by the way, but with lifestyle, you can affect your lipid levels dramatically in either direction. This idea that it's genetics and there's nothing we can do for the majority of us. We should always qualify these things in biology and medicine. There's always exceptions.
Right.
And there's always people who, you know, no matter what they do, their levels are not going to be great. Mm-hmm. Although even there, you could make the case that people who have bad genetics should really lean on the lifestyle to optimize. They'll never have what, you know, is considered a great LDL cholesterol level, but they'll have a relative improvement, you know, relative to their potential. You know, you got to play the hand you're dealt as best you can.